Oh, I thought it was a you.
And I'm just following along.
You.
It's Friday, which means this is our last day this week with speaker and author Michael McGill Jr.
Yeah, it's been great having you on.
It's been fun.
Yeah, it's been great.
Purpose-filled.
Today, Michael, we're going to be focusing on how to overcome fear.
Yes.
You're going to tell us how to do that, but I've always been told, and what I always practice is try to lean into the challenge.
Ooh, I love that. So the first tool that I give people is to, as you say, lean in. I say notice your triggers and notice your responses. You know, we live in a culture that often tells us to be fearless. And while I understand where that comes from, for me, I think that fear is a natural thing. It can be a healthy thing. What's unhealthy is when we allow fear to drive us versus guide us. Fear can be used as a good teaching moment. It can be used to support us, but we really want to be able to operate in a place of power and not fear. So write down, what do you notice when you become afraid? What do you notice? What does fear require of you? What does fear cause you to do? Write that down to become aware. So when I'm afraid, for me, I know that I get anxious in my stomach. I get anxious in my body. I can't sleep. So I'm becoming more aware of what fear looks like and how it shows up.
That kind of the same reactions as love, though, in a lot of ways.
Absolutely, yeah.
So you need to ask.
Oh, no.
Some people...
when they get that love feeling.
Yeah, but you say learn to ask the love versus fear question.
Oh, yeah. So when we think about making a choice, oftentimes we are afraid to operate. And so sometimes we operate and we make choices based on fear. But what I offer people is what I offer myself. It's the love versus fear question. So get you a piece of paper, get a chalkboard, write out, what would love require of me in this moment? And what would fear require? Or what would fear ask or encourage me to do? Mm. So for example, I'm about to embark on a journey where I'm literally shifting my entire life to go to a clinical fellowship program in counseling at Johns Hopkins. And so that is requiring me to literally shift to go over 1,000 miles away. And I'm leaving the stability. I'm leaving my comfort. I'm leaving my grandmother, who I love so dearly. I'm leaving my mother and my sister.
You're leaving us.
I'm leaving you all temporarily, right? And so fear would tell me to go, oh, no, you can't go, because sometimes I get afraid that my grandmother is getting older and that I won't be here to support her, to help her, as she's really helped to nurture me. And I get afraid and I want to stay. And I begin to go, okay, I can't go. I can't go. But love says you got to be liberated. Love says go chase that thing that you believe in. Love says that you'll be okay, and so will your granny. Mm. So what does love require of you?
So what about delay doesn't mean deny?
Yes, and so this is a part that I like. It's an adage that I can say, take me to church. Delay doesn't mean a denial. Oftentimes, our fears develop because we've been delayed, because we haven't been chosen. Our fears develop because the things have been delayed and we feel like it's a denial. But just like the birthing process with the baby and the mother, it goes in trimesters. You know, there's a part where it's expeditiously growing in the womb. Then there's a part where it's slowing down its growth process. So a delay doesn't mean a denial. You know, what I often encourage people to do is to write down what they've overcome. When you write down what you've overcome, you're putting application to your experience. Application to experience. Like Whitney Houston says, I didn't know my own strength. Or something like that, right? I crushed down, didn't crumble. Look, I'm getting my Broadway debut.
Wow.
But you don't know your own strength until you actually see it. So when you write down and examine what you've overcome and you see what you've been brought through, it encourages you to remember, I can keep going.
Well, write a good chapter about us. We're not losing you totally. We're going to do some Skype stuff when you get up to John Hopkins. And we appreate you being
with
us live.
Thank you. Thank you.
And I've known you since you were a little bit of kid. I'm so proud of you.
Thank you. I'm grateful. And so as I tell people that I'm telling myself, practice self-love, encourage yourself, nurture yourself on your journey, and keep on going.
Be good
to
yourself.
I'm not going to shake your hand because I'll hug
you. Yes. Grace for the race, y'all.
All right. Check out his Instagram or Twitter, Michael McGill Jr. He's also got a great website, McGillSpeaks.com. Well, let's eat.
Let's go.
Happy Friday.